Thank you very much, Speaker. I'm very pleased to be able to report to you and to all Victorians that today we have another day of zero new coronavirus cases across Victoria. The last time we had 2 0 days in a row was the 5th and 6th of March this year. This is an amazing achievement, one that belongs to every single Victorian who has followed the rules.
Government-imposed restrictions have led to a significant mental health effects on many Victorians. How many additional specialist psychiatric beds will the government provide to support Victorians who are currently not receiving appropriate care?
As we open up, we recognise that getting through this pandemic is only the first step. We need a Green New Deal for Victoria, a recovery plan that will create thousands of new jobs, but also look after people and our planet for generations.
What the bill does is it legislates for a model for non-violent, non-sexual offences in respect of people that have had, in the case of adults, a 10-year period of non-offending. The essence of this bill is that those that are able to move on with their lives, that can show genuine rehabilitation and change, ought be given a fair go as they seek employment, housing and a different life.
And I'd like to end with a statement that Claire read out this morning. Last month, the largest e-petition in Victorian history was tabled in Parliament. It demanded an end to convenience killing in our pounds and shelters. I created the petition after my healthy foster greyhound Dash was killed for treatable anxiety issues.
It's really important that we continue to lean into the very difficult and confronting and often traumatic elements of this particular motion, and that we recognise the good work that is being undertaken to make sure that animals like Dash, to make sure that animals like my Sophie, and like Boots, who was here at Parliament earlier today, not just these pointy-faced snooters, Hansard's going to ask me to spell that one out, who come into care and who are the most extraordinary, gentle, sensitive, loving animals that I could ever want, but for the countless other animals who deserve forever homes.
We join the government in not opposing this motion. Let us look at the possibilities. Let us look at what can be done to assist cats and dogs in particular, and let's ensure that we can go forward in a compassionate and caring way, not just for cats and dogs and companion animals, but also for those who care for them.
In our lives, we have moments of great significance. Those moments that you know exactly where you were and who you were with. And one such moment for me was the national apology to the Stolen Generations in 2008. And I had the extraordinary opportunity to be sitting in the gallery of the Australian House of Representatives that day and experience one of the most profoundly important acts of a parliament in the history of our democracy.
And I'd like today to acknowledge Mohammed Dagalich from Glenroy Secondary College, who was awarded third place in the Year 10 to 12 category of the 2020 Parliament Prize. Mohammed's video contribution spoke to an issue that is very close to my heart, being the plight of refugees and asylum seekers in our community.
Three Melbourne and Melbourne Victorian teams, the Vixens, the Richmond Tigers and Melbourne Storm, did us proud last weekend. These three teams showed the resilience of all Victorians. It's been a tough year for us all, and yet it was three Victorian teams with the full backing of their supporters at home who took out these national premierships.
Thank you, President. I wish to congratulate the AFL Premiers for 2020, the Richmond Football Club. A back-to-back premiership to match the 2019 result for the club. Everyone in this chamber is well aware of my passion for the Tigers, and in a year where there has been so little joy in Victoria, watching my Tigers play each week has brought me so much pleasure.